I'm here at Outlaws Boxing talking to boxer here, Brandon Krause, and today we're going to do a quick tutorial about throwing the overhand right, the punches, the punch that knocks out so many fighters. Brandon, who in the boxing world today has the best overhand right?
Who in the boxing world today has the best overhand right?
Who uses it most effectively, do you think?
Oh, man, that's a good question. I don't know, off the top of my head, some current guys, but some ones in the past that were great. Whereas I loved Lennox Lewis overhand right with level guys, and that was a taller guy coming over his shorter opponent's punches. Maybe a little more crude version of Ricardo Mayorga would end up hurting a lot of guys with his overhand right, including the excellent Vernon Forrest, in which he picked him up the welterweight title. But you know, throughout history, there's been a number of guys that work the overhand right. And yeah, look, a guy like Lennox, who is significantly taller than his opponents, can work it, can be throwing the straight, and then could come over the top of his opponent's guards with some serious power. Now me, for instance, who is usually shorter than my opponents, I need to be a little trickier about it. So what I end up doing is setting my guy up, showing him a lot of body shots, and then I like to feint to the body and come overhand, and this punch trails behind me because I try to get my opponent to pay attention to my eyes, and all of a sudden my eyes go down, but the punch comes up. Took me a while to master that shot and to make sure it landed where I wanted every time I threw it, and also to be in good position for after I miss, because you know what, in boxing, at least in my case, miss more than you land, all right? And what was happening, and when I tried to teach some of my younger guys this punch, they will go ahead and throw the punch, beautiful, right up until their waist, and then forget about their lower body. And what ends up happening is they basically put in all their eggs in one basket, lunging towards their opponent, and whether they hit or not, they end up falling off balance. So what's important about this shot is, regardless of your method of how you set it up, whether if it's off a feint, off a straight shot, is you need to step in with that lead foot. Understand that you're clearing a significant amount of distance here, so take that big step first, so I have a base in which to come down on.
One more time, coach, one more time.
So what I do, so this would be like a 1-2 combination, right? I step in, boom, boom, step back. In full speed, it would look like this, pop, pop, right? Now when I come for the overhand, I step longer and a little bit wider than that because I'm going to come over the top of my opponent's guard, all right? Think of a rainbow. Think of our, while we're getting some wraps ready and we'll wrap you up.
You got it? Or give me something, okay?
Think of a rainbow. Think of an arc. And also remember that it has to be knuckles first. You don't want to hit this guy with your fingers. So I start coming in for that shot. Footsteps before the fist starts coming, I drive my body down, this punch kind of trails behind me, and I hit my opponent, boom, there with my knuckles, and then I follow through in that downward motion. All right, so your uppercut comes from this angle. Mm-hmm. You can almost think of that overhand coming from the reverse of that shot.
Last question, coach. I'm in a heavy bag. How do I work on my overhand right on a heavy bag? Is there, or which bag? Which bag is the best for the off?
You know, something that has
like a double end bag,
some sort of roundness to it, because that's what you're trying to learn is how to
hit the face.
Your opponent there, and what you don't want to do is start bang landing like this. So, hey Charles, come on over here. Let's say I was boxing with Charles, who's significantly
Lennox Lewis in the house,
right? And this would be a good method in which to strike my opponent with, right? I have to set him up. It's a bad technical shot if I just keep going, if I just go after him. If I were to just go, he would see it coming. He'd probably counter me in the meantime. But if I can get a little slick about it, if I can show him the jab, show him the right, show him the jab. And now, feint that body, bang, and come over the top of it. I can catch this guy blind, make it a very devastating shot.
One more time,
shot.
Coach. One more time.
So, and this is one of 100 different ways to set this up. I'm showing him a lot of straight punches. I'm changing my level a lot. And I want him to start picking up on the fact that I'm changing levels, trying to defend this body shot, right? And once I see that his elbows are coming in to defend that shot, I know I have him. and I'll fake that shot. His elbows will come in, and then the shot will come over the guard.
There you have it, Brandon Krause talking about the overhand right. Thanks for the explanation. Thanks, Charles. There you have it. EsNews.com. I'm Melissa back reporting.